Now, from across the tri-state, this is KHQA Sports.
What was a great day of postseason action all around the area in track and golf, and we'll get to those results shortly. Let us begin on the diamond, though. Riggsville, Perry, and Liberty going at it. It was all about the pitchers in the early going. This is Liberty's Isaac Murfin using the off-speed stuff right there to strand two runners in the first inning. He was very effective. He would leave another runner on base here in the second, and he was hard to hit in the early going. But finally, Riggsville, Perry rattles the bats in the middle innings. It's Wyatt Bradshaw doubling to center field. Gets just about every bit of this one, just about leaves the yard as well. That puts him on second base. And next up, Caleb Bradshaw, and he would trade places with Wyatt with an RBI double, puts the Riggsville up 1-0 at that point. And speaking of pitching, Dryden Craven, very tough to get to today. He gets the win. You'll see him get a strikeout here in the fourth inning, as Riggsville Perry also gets the win 2-0 today over Liberty. They improved to 15-6 on the year. Scores: Q&D gets a good win today over Chatham Glenwood. Justin Tolman, a complete game two-hitter there. It was Rushville Industry falling to Abingdon 4-2. Route blanks Brown County 2-0. Pace and Seymour 10-3 over Pleasant Hill. And Macomb gets a cycle from Brett Taylor, 10-0 shutout there over Southeastern. West Hancock 10-2 winners over Unity. And Brimfield 10-9 over Beardstown, Missouri. It was Hannibal falling to Marshall 2-1. And Palmyra gets 13 strikeouts from Will Funkenbush, 1-0 there. Canton 11-3 winners over Highland. Scotland County wins 2 today, first over Putnam 11-1, and over North Shelby. Final score there was 14-0. Softball: Riggsville gets a great day from Hannah DeWitt, 8 RBIs and 2 home runs, 17-10 winners over Payson in that one. Also, Payson playing Pleasant Hill, and they won 12-2. Kristen Luce, her fourth consecutive game with a home run. That's very good. And also, West Prairie 11-3 winners over Central. Mentioned we had golf. You may have seen this at 6 p.m. today. We'll show you a little bit of a catch-up. Class 2 sectional. Palmyra, the team to watch today. This is their number one. Hunter Baggett at Norwood's golf course. That was a birdie putt on 2. Good effort from the fridge. As I mentioned, very fast greens earlier today. These were tough to putt on. He taps in for a par. Here's his third shot in the par 4, number 3. A great approach. Unfortunately, he would finish with bogey on this hole. He was 1 over through 4 holes. And then Baggett would kind of turn it on in the back 9. A nice putt there. Also, right behind him was Palmyra's number 2 today, Trevor DeHaan. Tricky putt here for par, but he gets it to go. As Palmyra, their individuals really didn't have to worry about making the cut because the whole team is going to state. We'll show you their final score here. Great day for Palmyra. They advance to state as they win by 2 strokes over Macon, 344 to 346. It was Lammers from Southern Boone leading the way, though, with an even par today, as Hunter Baggett finishes 4th on his own. So Palmyra going to state. How about Hannibal Class 2 sectional at Innsbruck Resort? It was hole number 13. This is Scott Cockrell. He would finish 9 over on the day. Misjudged the distance on this par 3, but a great chip, and this is what you have to do at the state level. You got to get up and down. Great chip. Leaves him with a tap in for the par. Also, Alec Abel good today as well. Birdie on the long and difficult 9th here. This one makes you cringe a little bit. Kisses the outside of the cup there, but he would make the tough par putt coming back. And speaking of Cockrell and Abel, they both are going to state as well, as Hannibal finishes 3rd as a team, as the team is not going to state because they only take the top 2 in the sectional, but individuals Alec Abel and Scott Cockrell both going to state, so congratulations to those two. Also, didn't have these results for you at 6. Louisiana wins its Class 1 sectional, ties for first with a 320, so that whole team going to state. They were led by Greg Pitzer, co-medalist today, with a 13 over par. Other state qualifiers we can tell you about in Class 1, Zach Dye from Canton and Ethan Pott from Ellsbury. All those guys going to state, which begins on May 13th and 14th. A lot of track results to give you from earlier today. Hannibal boys are your NCMC champions. They take first place as the girls take 4th place. And as you can imagine, a ton of individual winners in this meet today. Those will all be posted for you on connecttristates.com. The highlight there, Markel Strickland wins 3 titles, triple jump, 110 and 300 meter hurdles. Also, Western Big 6 conference meet for the girls. Moline wins things as QHS takes 5th, but McKenna Baker does win the title in shot put. Also, West Central Championships boys team results. It was Monmouth Roseville followed by Macomb and Illini West in 3rd. On the girls' side of things, Illini West takes 1st, followed by Sherrard and Macomb in 3rd there. Prairie Land Conference, great day for Rushville Industry. The boys and girls both take 1st. Your highlights here, Brady Crane wins the 110 and 300 hurdles. And Megan Lozon, who is your Student Athlete of the Week later this week, you'll hear from her on Wednesday, she wins the shot put and the discus. Finally, we'll wrap it up with a couple of soccer scores. QHS girls get a nice win over Galesburg tonight, 6-0. Kaylee Kuhlman, 2 goals and an assist in that one. Hannibal, I'll say it again, the team that just won't lose. They beat Ellsbury tonight 10-0. Raylan Charlton, 4 goals in that one. Hannibal now 17-5. Holy Trinity blanks Canton 2-0. Megan Spears, ridiculous day in the net, 18 saves there. It was Holy Trinity boys beating Central Lee. Mitch Muller with a hat trick there as Holy Trinity now ranked 5th in the Class 1A polls. Illinois boys tennis, Quincy High falls to Sacred Heart Griffin 7-2. They will play against Q&D tomorrow at Reservoir Park. And also, John Woods softball ends its season tonight. Final score there was 8-2. In the Region 24 quarterfinals, but the first winning season for John Woods softball since 05-06.